I didn't set out to study how endangered ecosystems respond to catastrophic hurricanes, but then I woke up on September 10th, 2017, and this was happening.
Hurricane Irma devouring Florida tonight.
Irma has made landfall in the Florida Keys.
These storm chasers clocking speeds at 100.
I spent all morning refreshing the radar on my phone because the eastern eyewall of Hurricane Irma was on top of Big Pine Key, where I had been working for 6 years and had set up an experiment 2 years before. The experiment I set up was to study populations of this plant, Croton linearis, because it's the sole host plant for two endangered butterflies, Bartram scrub-haristreak and Florida leafwings. And these species only live in pine rockland forests, which are only found in a narrow strip of high elevation land in South Florida. Historically, these forests burn really regularly, and Croton relies on that fire to maintain the open structure of the forest. Now that habitat is surrounded by neighborhoods and strip malls, and that makes it really hard to put fire on the ground. In the last half century, Croton populations have crashed in places without fire, and that's really devastating for these two butterflies that rely on this plant. So my original experiment was to test whether we could use mechanical clearing as a surrogate for prescribed fire and still have positive benefits for the plants and the butterflies. So mechanical clearing is like fire in that it opens up the understory, but it leaves behind this layer of mulch that new plants have to push up through to access sunlight. My original intent was to compare mechanically cleared forests to forests that were unmanaged, but then Hurricane Irma hit it all. So here's what my field sites looked like before the hurricane and then after. And during Irma, the whole island was overwashed with storm surge, and really strong winds blew debris out of the trees and all over everything. When I went back and collected data after the storm, now my data could tell us about how the management that we'd done prior to the storm interacted with the effects of the hurricane. So when we look at all of our data across all of our sites, the storm was bad for Croton, but the worst place to be was in unmanaged sites. We had higher survival rates in places that had been previously mechanically cleared, and the highest survival rates were in places that had been burned. It can get a little depressing thinking about whether or not the decisions that we make now actually matter in the face of a change in climate, but I think it's really important that we're doing these best management practices, like using prescribed fire on a regular basis to maintain current populations and species. And that not only does that maintain them now, but it gives them a chance to weather big catastrophic storms like hurricanes.